tell me a little bit about when you were 18 years old, and you know, you had the idea that, you know, maybe stripping is this thing for me to do. Tell me a little bit about how you got to that place.
I played one season in football in college, and I just, it wasn't exactly what I wanted it to be, so I just came home, and I didn't have a clue what I wanted to do. I didn't really want to go to school, and so I was just like, all right, get money, so you don't have to like ask for your parents to give you money. And I pretty much worked like 5 jobs. Stripping was just sort of one of them. And I just heard it on the radio. I was like, I can dance. You know, I played, I'm, you know, athletic. So I just went down there and got the part and just started.
No,
a lot of nerves. Nerves. A lot of embarrassing, humbling moments. Because I was kind of the little guy. Like, all the rest of the guys were gargantuan sort of muscle dudes. And thank God I could dance, you know. So that kind of worked out for me.
How much money were you making?
Not that much. You'd be surprised. Like, but it's non-taxable, and I mean, it's essentially like cash, and you're only doing it for about an hour and a half or 2 hours at max. And,
right.
You know, it's essentially just a big party. So you make about 150, 150, 175.
I mean, when you were 18,
then,
19 years old, that's not
a
bad
lot
money.
Of money. Doing that 4-5 nights a week sometimes, like, that's a good bit of money.
Yeah, yeah. And tell me about the differences or the behavior of the audiences. I mean, you know, you hear stories about female strippers often and the way that they sort of have to deal with the customers. What was it like dealing with the customers in your situation?
Well, I think it's kind of awesome, to be totally honest, that the women finally have a place that they can go and, like, just turn rabid. And, like, they lose all their inhibitions and just sort of go nuts for, you know, an hour. Like, because I don't think there's that many places that women are allowed to do that without other women or men, like, looking at them in weird ways. And guys, for somehow, they're just Neanderthals, and we can just feel like we do whatever we want to do. But I think that when they lock the doors, their nails grew longer, their hair grew more coarse, their teeth grew, like, they just completely went feral, and it was just no holds barred. Like, it just was.
Any uncomfortable moments for you?
There's a lot of uncomfortable moments. One of my favorite ones is like the first night I ever like went on stage. I like, you know, afterwards you get on a girl and start giving her a lap dance as you do. And the lady, like, looked up at me and, like, she's like, you remind me of my nephew. And it was, it took me a minute to realize what she had said. And I was just like, wow, this is going to be a really weird trip.
And so do you just kind of tune out a little bit? Like, do you have to sort of put your mind somewhere else?
No? I mean, it's not painful. Like, I didn't do it because it sucked. I did it because it was crazy and fun, you know. Yeah. And there were nights that you didn't want to do it, you know, obviously, just like there's anything. But it was fun. Like, it was a complete party.
Right.
Like, every time that you went, it was a party.
Well, one of the producers said about this movie that your life was way crazier than stuff that's in the movie. And they said, if you put the stuff that actually happened to him in this movie, nobody would believe it. Can you enlighten us a little bit?
I won't enlighten you on the stuff because, you know, it's just, I don't think that, not that I'm ashamed of it, I just, you know, don't want my wife's family probably hearing
of
this stuff.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, yeah.
No, but, like, I never
OD'd.
This
is Canada, though. They won't know.
Yeah, they'll get back somehow. but, no, I mean, I never OD'd in my real life. That wasn't anything that happened. Everything that happened in the story is pretty much fabricated for story's sake.
Right.
And look, it's not that it was so crazy. It was just bizarre.
Well, so the movie, I mean, it's a fictionalized version of it. What do you want people to take away about this job? Do you want, are you trying to teach people something here or just...
You know, someone else asked me if is it a cautionary tale. You know, it's not a genre movie. It's not a comedy or a drama or, you know, a thriller or anything. I think it's just a bit of slice of life. I mean, I think every life or slice of life is a bit cautionary. I don't know if anybody's going to take anything away other than, you know, this is a window into a world that I've never seen. So they're going to take that away. And just the fact that, you know, Mike, I think just like a lot of people find themselves in a job that they never expected to have, and you know, it's just kind of eaten up about 6 years of his life, and he realized that this is not what I wanted to do.